Hi, I'm Lorna, and I sing Alto 2 in Reading Phoenix Choir. My lockdown quarantine is Cristobal de Morales' O Magnum Mysterium. I love singing Renaissance music, and I love singing sacred music, and this piece sits nicely in the intersection of the two. We sang it many times in many concerts, most notably in San Salamanca Cathedral in our tour to Spain, which was an absolutely wonderful setting to sing this piece. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Hi, my name's Alice and I am one of the first sopranos with Reading Phoenix Choir. Today I want to share with you my quarantune, which is Thomas Tallis's If Ye Love Me. I've chosen this piece not because I used to sing it, but I was in the choir when the tenors and basses used to sing it. And it was in the repertoire around the time that I got married. And I remember frequently, you know, listening to them rehearse it and perform it. And just really enjoyed the music, and now listening to it, it brings me a sort of comfort and reminds me of one of the happiest times of my life. So I hope you enjoy it.
Hello, I'm Edna. I'm an alto 2 in Reading Phoenix Choir, and my lockdown current tune is Abendlied by Josef Rheinberger. It's always been my favorite choir piece, and when I moved to Reading and I searched for a choir, I found a recording of Abendlied on YouTube by Reading Phoenix Choir. And I listened to it, and this made me go to the open rehearsal. So enjoy.
Hello, my name is Dan Bignall, and I am a former member of the Reading Phoenix Choir, singing in its baritone section. My choice of quarrin tune is Os Iusti by Anton Bruckner. Os Iusti stands for Mouth of the Righteous, and as a deeply religious man, this Gregorian chant was supposed to be sung as part of the Mass. He wrote it for his choir master, who, upon receipt, asked, "Is this it?" Which I thought was rather brusque and ungracious, but prompted Bruckner to add in a second verse, the Iveni David, or I Have Found David, and the final Alleluia. This piece means a lot to me personally because it was the first song that I ever sang with Reading Phoenix Choir, or any choir at all. I mean, I came into it not knowing much about sight reading or music theory in any way, shape or form. And it was also one of the standout pieces that was sung at my wedding. I will never forget, never forget, singing this in York Minster, with its 5-second reverb trail that diminished off into serene nothingness. It was absolutely beautiful. So please enjoy this piece of music, stay safe, and stay hydrated.
Thank you. Hi everyone, my name is Heidi and I sing soprano in the choir. My quarantine choice is Gustav Holst's Nunc Dimittis. It's my favourite piece of our current repertoire. It is doubly special for me. Not only is it a beautiful piece of choral music, but my husband and I sang it along with several current and former members of Phoenix at our wedding. I hope you enjoy it.
Hi, I'm Rosie and I sing soprano in the choir. The piece I've chosen for my quarantine is Bogorodice Dievo by Rachmaninoff. I've mainly chosen this because it's a beautiful piece, but also because it's something that has come back into the repertoire several times since I've sung in the choir. When we sing this in concerts, it's a piece that really seems to captivate the audience, and there's always a few moments of stillness at the end before we have any applause. I hope you enjoy this recording of the piece, which is from our tour of Spain.
Oh. name is Jenny Jenkins, and I sing soprano with Reading Phoenix Choir. My quorum tune is Requiem Aeternam 1 from Howell's Requiem. When composing his Requiem, Herbert Howells was inspired by the glow of light inside Gloucester Cathedral as the sun shone through its great east window. An image of Howells stood marvelling at this scene has come to mind whenever we have sung this piece. I really hope you enjoy listening to it.
Hi, I'm Fiona and I sing second soprano in Reading Phoenix Choir. My quarantune's choice is Song for Athene by John Taverner. I love the way this piece builds, starting with seemingly nothing up until its grand climax. When I first joined the choir, I was given a DVD of recordings of concerts, this DVD actually, to help me learn some of the pieces. And the recording you're about to see comes from the 2011 Wales Next the Sea concert, which was on this DVD. It was one of the first times I actually saw the choir perform in full, and I remember being blown away by the sound. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do.